Question: Explain the concept of pre-hospital communication with trauma communication. Technologies in trauma care. Answer: Pre-hospital communication with trauma communication technologies involves using advanced technologies such as telemedicine and remote communication for effective consultation and information exchange. Effective use of technology supports timely decision-making in trauma care. Question: Describe the management approach for a patient with suspected traumatic shoulder ligament injury. Answer: In a patient with suspected traumatic shoulder ligament injury, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as MRI or ultrasound, and potential non-operative management or surgical intervention are necessary based on the extent of ligament damage and functional impairment. Question: Describe the management approach for a patient with suspected traumatic shoulder fracture. Answer: In a patient with suspected traumatic shoulder fracture, imaging studies such as X-rays or MRI are performed to assess the extent of injury. Non-operative management or surgical intervention may be chosen based on the fracture type and stability. Question: Discuss the management of a patient with a suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury. Answer: In a patient with suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as CT scan or angiography, and surgical intervention are necessary to prevent fatal complications and address vascular integrity.
Question: Discuss the management of a suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury. Answer: In a patient with suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as CT scan or angiography, and surgical intervention are necessary to prevent fatal complications and address vascular integrity. Question: Explain the concept of pre-hospital communication with trauma communication. Technologies in trauma care. Answer: Pre-hospital communication with trauma communication technologies involves using advanced technologies such as telemedicine and remote communication for effective consultation and information exchange. Effective use of technology supports timely decision-making in trauma care. Question: Describe the management approach for a patient with suspected traumatic knee ligament injury. Answer: In a patient with suspected traumatic knee ligament injury, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as MRI or arthroscopy, and potential non-operative management or surgical intervention are necessary based on the extent of ligament damage and functional impairment. Question: Describe the anatomical zones used for classifying abdominal injuries in trauma. Answer: Abdominal injuries are often classified into anatomical zones based on the location of the trauma. The zones include: Zone I includes injuries to the thoracoabdominal region, from the clavicles to the bottom of the rib cage. Zone 2 represents injuries to the epigastric and umbilical regions, covering the area between the bottom of the rib cage and the umbilicus. Zone 3 encompasses injuries to the hypogastric region, extending from the umbilicus to the pelvic bone.
Question: Discuss the management of a patient with a suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury. Answer: In a patient with suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as CT scan or angiography, and surgical intervention are necessary to prevent fatal complications and address vascular integrity. Question: Explain the concept of pre-hospital communication with trauma communication. Technologies in trauma care. Answer: Pre-hospital communication with trauma communication technologies involves using advanced technologies such as telemedicine and remote communication for effective consultation and information exchange. Effective use of technology supports timely decision-making in trauma care. Question: Describe the management approach for a patient with suspected traumatic elbow tendon injury. Answer: In a patient with suspected traumatic elbow tendon injury, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as ultrasound or MRI, and potential non-operative management or surgical intervention are necessary based on the extent of tendon damage and functional impairment. Question: Discuss the management of a patient with a suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury? Answer, in a patient with suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury. Clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as CT scan or angiography, and surgical intervention are necessary to prevent fatal complications and address vascular integrity. Question, explain the concept of pre-hospital communication with trauma communication. Technologies in trauma care. Answer, pre-hospital communication with trauma communication technologies involves using advanced technologies such as telemedicine and remote communication for effective consultation and information exchange. Effective use of technology supports timely decision-making in trauma care. Question, describe the management approach for a patient with suspected traumatic shoulder dislocation. Answer, in a patient with suspected traumatic shoulder dislocation, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as X-rays or MRI, and prompt reduction are necessary to restore joint alignment and assess associated injuries. Question, discuss the management of a patient with a suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury. Answer, in a patient with suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as CT scan or angiography, and surgical intervention are necessary to prevent fatal complications and address vascular integrity. Question, explain the concept of pre-hospital communication with trauma communication. Technologies in trauma care. Answer, pre-hospital communication with trauma communication technologies involves using advanced technologies such as telemedicine and remote communication for effective consultation and information exchange. Effective use of technology supports timely decision-making in trauma care. Question, discuss the management of a patient with a suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury. Answer, in a patient with suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as CT scan or angiography, and surgical intervention are necessary to prevent fatal complications and address vascular integrity. Question, explain the concept of pre-hospital communication with trauma communication. Technologies in trauma care. Answer, pre-hospital communication with trauma communication technologies involves using advanced technologies such as telemedicine and remote communication for effective consultation and information exchange. Effective use of technology supports timely decision-making in trauma care. Question, describe the management approach for a patient with suspected traumatic shoulder cartilage injury. Answer, in a patient with suspected traumatic shoulder cartilage injury, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as MRI, and potential non-operative management or surgical intervention, such as arthroscopy, are necessary based on the extent of cartilage damage and functional impairment. Question, discuss the management of a suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury. Answer, in a patient with suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as CT scan or angiography, and surgical intervention are necessary to prevent fatal complications and address vascular integrity. Question, explain the concept of pre-hospital communication with trauma communication. Technologies in trauma care. Answer, pre-hospital communication with trauma communication technologies involves using advanced technologies such as telemedicine and remote communication for effective consultation and information exchange. Effective use of technology supports timely decision-making in trauma care. Question, describe the management approach for a patient with suspected traumatic shoulder nerve injury. Answer, in a patient with suspected traumatic shoulder nerve injury, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as ultrasound or nerve conduction studies, and potential non-operative management or surgical intervention are necessary based on the extent of nerve damage and functional impairment.
Question, describe the management approach for a patient with suspected traumatic knee dislocation. Answer, in a patient with suspected traumatic knee dislocation, clinical evaluation, imaging studies such as X-rays or CT scan, and prompt reduction are necessary to restore joint alignment and assess associated injuries. Question: discuss the management of a suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury. Answer: in a patient with suspected traumatic abdominal vascular injury, clinical evaluation. Imaging studies such as CT scan or angiography and surgical intervention are necessary to prevent fatal complications and address vascular integrity. Question: explain the concept of pre-hospital communication with trauma communication. Technologies in trauma care. Answer: pre-hospital communication with trauma communication technologies involves using advanced technologies such as telemedicine and remote communication for effective consultation and information exchange. Effective use of technology supports timely decision-making in trauma care. Question: describe the management approach for a patient with suspected traumatic knee fracture. Answer: in a patient with suspected traumatic knee fracture, imaging studies such as X-rays or MRI are performed to assess the extent of injury. Non-operative management or surgical intervention may be chosen based on the fracture type and stability. Question: how can the risk of hemorrhage be managed in stomach injury? Answer: managing the risk of hemorrhage in stomach injury involves controlling bleeding vessels, achieving hemostasis, and ensuring meticulous surgical technique during repair. Question: what is the role of pyloric exclusion in managing severe stomach injuries? Answer: pyloric exclusion involves suturing the pylorus closed to prevent the passage of gastric contents through the duodenum. It can be used in cases of severe stomach injuries to promote healing.
Question: explain the concept of pre-hospital communication with trauma communication. Technologies in trauma care. Answer: pre-hospital communication with trauma communication technologies involves using advanced technologies such as telemedicine and remote communication for effective consultation and information exchange. Effective use of technology supports timely decision-making in trauma care. Question: describe the management approach for a patient with suspected traumatic elbow cartilage injury. Answer: in a patient with suspected traumatic elbow cartilage injury, clinical evaluation. Imaging studies such as MRI and potential non-operative management or surgical intervention, such as arthroscopy, are necessary based on the extent of cartilage damage and functional impairment.